Good morning, student. Today we are going to start our second unit. Second unit is single phase induction motors, and it is for as per teaching learning scheme 14 marks unit. First unit is a three phase induction motor, which is earlierly we have complete, and it is a 20 marks unit. Now here in this unit 14 marks syllabus are present as per MSBT syllabus, and in this session, means in this topic, in this unit, we are going to see induction motor starting performance, its characteristics, construction, working, and different types of induction motors, along with their application, advantages and disadvantages. And finally, we are also seeing maintenance of a single phase induction motor. So, not taking more time, we are starting our today's session. Today we are start our first unit is a 2.1 second unit. 2.1 is a double field revolving theory and principle of making these motors self-starting. So first, be clear that induction motor is not self-starting. So that first of all, we are starting the double field revolving theory, and by which this theory explain, means double field revolving theory explain the performance of single phase induction motor. And for this purpose, first of all, everybody says as seen here, we know that this is the supply nature of single phase sinusoidal wave. Means single phase supply consists of two cycles, means labeled as a positive half cycle, and second one is a negative half cycle. We may here a represented axis as a time is t, and y axis is a voltage or current or power. So here what happened, due to single phase supply nature, the induction motor produces the torque, means due to which the flux are first of all created. We say here it is the rotor, and on rotor here total flux is a phi m, means here the flux produced in a positive half cycle and negative half cycle, this flux is a phi m, means this flux is appear in the air gap. Now what happens, the positive half cycle produces half of the resultant flux, means here phi m is the resultant flux. And plus phi m upon 2 is the flux produced by positive half cycle. Say it is in this direction, means phi m upon 2, and here plus phi m upon 2, but after some interval, means negative half cycle appears, and in negative half cycle what happens, the opposite types of magnetic flux, means say it is a minus phi m upon 2, means negative half cycle produces minus phi upon 2 plus here minus phi m upon 2 is the flux produced by negative half cycle of the supply. So what happened? At the end of cycle, these cycles are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So that at the end of every cycle, what happened? The net resultant flux means phi m becomes zero, because here these fluxes, these cycles are identical, equal in magnitude but having different magnitude, opposite directions means positive half cycle and negative half cycle. No doubt the fluxes are same but direction is opposite, so that at the end the net resultant flux phi m will be zero, and due to which what happens? See here, here we are seeing torque slip characteristics. But here what happened? Due to this positive half cycle flux produces torque T1, means here T1 is the torque produced by flux phi m upon 2. Similarly here T2 is, means it is a torque, it is the torque produced by negative half cycle flux, and it is a minus phi m upon 2. But we know that resultant flux is, resultant flux is T is a resultant torque, and it is T is equal to T1 plus T2, means here T1 is the torque produced by flux produced due to positive half cycle, means plus phi m upon 2. T2 is the torque produced by negative half cycle flux, it is minus phi m upon 2. Here we have already seen both the fluxes are in opposite direction, so here torque is also produces in opposite direction. But what happened? The net torque means T is a resultant torque due to T is a resultant torque produced by the complete cycle of the supply, means one cycle completed, torque T, but resultant torque is a T1 upon T2. But in this case, here we may say that T1 is equal to T2, because both the fluxes are same and its equal magnitude but opposite direction. Hence T1 is equal to T2, means amount, quantity amount is same. Say this torque is a 10 Newton meter. It is also 10 Newton meters. But what happened in this case? direction is the difference. Means here we may write likewise in this expression t is equal to t1 plus minus t1. Here t2 is equal to t1, means we have written t1, but here the direction of t2 is opposite to t1, means here direction is opposite, hence we are taking minus sign, means t is equal to t equal to t1 minus t1 is equal to 0. Means at the end of every cycle of supply, torque becomes 0. Means at the end of every cycle, torque becomes 0. That's why single phase induction motor does not self-starting. Here I again repeat that, firstly we are see that supply nature, supply has a two cycle, one positive cycle, positive half cycle, second one is a negative half cycle. Positive half cycle produces plus 5m upon 2, negative half cycle produces minus 5 upon 2. Both the fluxes are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Now the resultant flux becomes 0 because 5m is equal to 5m plus 2 minus 5m upon 2. Means here we may note that 5m is equal to plus 5m upon 2 minus 5m upon 2 is equal to 0. Means net resultant flux will be 0. And this can be explained by using torque slip characteristics. Here we are drawing torque slip characteristics. X-axis is the torque, right? And x-axis is the slip or speed. Y-axis is the torque. Here supply cycle, positive cycle plus 5m upon 2 produces torque T1. Means here we are noting, write down notation, T1 is a torque produced by plus 5m upon 2, means flux produced in the positive half cycle. Now similarly T2 is the torque produced by minus 5 upon 2, means it is the torque, it is the flux produced in negative half cycle. Now what happened? The T is a resultant torque and it can be known, it can be measured or calculated by addition of the both the torque produced in the positive half cycle and negative half cycle. But what happened? We know that T1 is equal to T2, means both the torque are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, and here we are written as T is equal to T1 plus minus T1. Here T2 is replaced by T1, but direction of T2 is the opposite as compared to T1. Means here minus sign are taken, and finally T is equal to T1 minus T1. Net resultant torque produced by every cycle at the end of every supply cycle will be 0. Means net torque at the end of every cycle is 0. That's why the single phase induction motor does not self-starting, and this performance is explained by double field revolving theory. So here double field revolving theory are concluded. Student may write all the theory as per the modal data, modal notes provided to you, and we'll continue principle of making motor self-starting. Then how we should start the induction motor by self-starting manner? So for this types of modification, some mechanical, some electrical rearrangement, electrical devices are using. These are seen in the next session.